chill that down a bit.
I'll put that a little bit too high. How's that looking? Yeah, that's looking alright. Just doing a quick audio check. Yeah, we're all good. Hello everyone, welcome to Fallout 1 2021 stream. So, I was originally going to do one for the Turkish Grand Prix on the Saturday or Sunday. Turns out, Turkish Grand Prix is not on this game. So, what I'm deciding to do instead today is I'm going to do the DLC that came out about a month ago, which is the Portuguese Grand Prix. I believe it's in Lisbon. Or Algarve, I guess. I can't remember if they've added other tracks since then. I think that's the only one they've done so far. But I just know that Turkey's not on here. Because it just goes straight from Sochi to Singapore. So, yeah, I'll be doing the Portuguese Grand Prix, full-length race. I'm going to actually be the winner of the Turkish Grand Prix, Valtteri Bottas. So, I've not really raced on this circuit before. Like I said, I've never done this circuit. I just want to make sure that my rules are correct. I'll keep these on. Weekend structure, one-shot qualifying, full race, weather and time of day. I'm going to make it clear, just because I don't really want to, you know, that can stay on 50. Manual race starts, collisions on. And we'll start the event. And whilst I do that, I will share this to the socials. Yeah, it's been a while since I've been on Formula 1. Like I said, I was going to do one for the Turkish Grand Prix, but it's not there. So that's why I'm doing it now. I was going to say, I'd be intrigued if there is commentary for this race, but there isn't. It's awkwardly quiet. Alright, just got a couple more socials to do. I won't be too long. Just give me a sec. These are alphabetical, aren't they? Okay, they're not exactly alphabetical. Well, some are. I don't even know what the order of these flags are. Like, what they've ordered them in. Why can't I find the Portugal flag? I found North Macedonia. But yeah, it's like Austria's next to Hungary. So it's like, it's not the most accurate. There's Portugal. And then change that to purple. So it won't be too long. Should be all good now. There we go. Okay. I'm gonna stick on more OSW review in the background. Just. Okay. So yeah, I'm gonna be trying to get used to this circuit. I never raced on it before. I almost said roast, I was like, that's not the correct word. Yeah, but difficulty 50, I'd say that's a competent difficulty setting. That's a good start. It's that corner. I think it's because I'm accelerating around it. Yeah, what was I thinking? Yeah, the race was fine last weekend. One exciting thing for me was Mick Schumacher got out of quali 3 in a Haas. That's very impressive. It was unfortunate he didn't do too well in the race. Hamilton started building his way back up and then got in a bit of an argument with his team, which it's nothing new. Hamilton's big moaner. I appreciate the fact that he's won several world championships and all that stuff, but just about every race he's just complaining. If he's not winning, he's complaining. And it's sometimes you don't win, you just accept it, you try and do the best you can. And he was 11th at that point. He started 11th. Technically got pole and then started 11th. So he's just doing what he can, I guess. But I don't know. Yeah, I did enjoy
it's time to
the
remind ourselves
liveries
of our
for Red Bull.
Bottas,
that was pretty cool.
Verstappen and Lewis Hamilton. Well, that wraps up qualifying.
So
but don't
we
worry,
had.
We'll be back tomorrow.
It was more of a white. It was more just white and red rather than the blue, red, and yellow. I quite liked it. I really enjoyed McLaren's one. I think it was for Monaco. That was a pretty cool one.
You join us in Portimao as we prepare for what will undoubtedly be a magnificent day of racing. It's with the race minutes away from starting. Here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Perez, Charles Leclerc, and Sainz, Ricciardo, Norris, Gasly, and Fernando Alonso, Ocon, Vettel, Lance Stroll, and Tsunoda, Raikkonen, Russell, Antonio Giovinazzi, and Mick Schumacher, Latifi, and Nikita Mazepin. That's it then, it's time to go racing as we head to trackside for today's race.
Here we go, where we go. How many laps we got? 66. Can't remember what the average lap time was. Must have been a minute 20 or something. I guess we'll get pissed on that. Most races tend to be 90 minutes, so hopefully, if everything goes smoothly, I'll be done in an hour 45. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. that corner again. I gotta learn not to accelerate on that corner. I'm doing very well on this radius already. Not even done a lap and I've spun out twice. That's like 125 is the average of that.
We can now use DRS. DRS now available.
I feel like this might be a long one, but we'll see how it goes. Yeah, we had England versus Andorra during the weekend as well. Pretty much what you expected in that match. England won 5-0. Andorra didn't get much attack. Spun in the same corner again. And yeah, Andorra didn't get much offense. Our highlight when me and my friend Will were watching it was they had to sub one of their defenders early, so this 41-year-old came on. And we're like, go on, do really good. And then he pulled his hamstring trying to chase Sancho down. And we're like, oh no. I don't even know what race is next for Formula 1. I probably should have looked that up. I'll probably do one for that. It depends what it is. I'm going to be busy all of next week, so there won't be any streams next week. But I will try and do some this week. I apologise if not. I've got a really busy week coming up. So, yeah.
Gap behind us is 9.0 seconds.
I don't enjoy the OSW guys. I've only recently gotten their stuff a couple of weeks back, but I've watched probably about 70% of their stuff right now. A lot of it is about like an hour and a half to 2.5 hours long. I've been pretty much watching them throughout each day. Not necessarily in order, but I've watched the majority of them now. Currently watching the ECW December to Dismember review, which is their 43rd, which they would have done back in 2015, I think. Let's try not to spin on this corner. I gotta go wide. Well, Gasly is up to 5th. Check him out.
The gap to the car behind is 14.4 seconds.
I'm putting a decent gap, which is nice. It seems to be the same thing with these races, is Hamilton and Verstappen get quite a distance away from the next drivers. So they're guaranteed 2nd, 3rd. Perez is always 4th. Almost saved it.
A new fastest lap of the race.
What's the pit window? 19 to 25, so we're going for a 2-stop.
We're leading our teammate by 22.3 seconds.
Trying to think what else there is to... Well, I think England are playing Hungary tomorrow. It is in England this time. So, hopefully the racism won't be as bad. I mean, it still will be, because, unfortunately, the east side of Europe, a lot of them, I'm not saying all of them, a lot of them, are known to be very racist. Yeah, it happens in Hungary, I think Slovenia, Russia, yeah, around that area. You know, before the Andorra match, there was a fire. I think apparently it was an accident. It conveniently took out the VAR system. But yeah, it's just a... it's like... Let's just hope they've... I would say let's hope they've learned, but it's one of those things, unfortunately, it's like... We've been trying for several years, but some people just don't change. And I think the simple solution is just... Not like ignore them, but... Just try and prove the point of what they're doing is wrong, and if they can't pay an indifference to it, then we can label them as racist, essentially. You know, it's one of those things. Either they've got to accept that change, like it's such a weird thing to say it's a change. It shouldn't have been a thing in the first place. Like, you know, judging people based on the color of their skin or where they're from. It should be about the personality, not, you know. It's like, I haven't looked into it or anything. I genuinely, as a person, do not get the concept of racism and sexism. It's like, we're all part of the same species, so why should the colour of someone's skin or, you know, the gender of a person, or even the sexuality of a person, completely change how we see the person? Because the person, we get with like transgender people, like some people, like they're born one gender and they feel like they're part of the other, so they change that way. You know, the thing is, the personality doesn't change. Like, the person's still the same regardless of if they do change their body. You know, like if they feel like there's something else, then fair enough. But it's so bizarre, like attacking someone based on the colour of their skin or just their gender, because it's not something it's kind of weird saying it's not something they change. Like, race is something you can't really change, and I wouldn't. It's such a, like, it's one of those things you gotta be careful with, where it's like, I'm like trying to say certain phrases, but I don't want it to be taken out of context, because that's like another bad thing as well. Like, you can try and defend something, but someone will take it out of context, make it look worse off than you actually mean, which I don't. I'm all for equality. It should have been, like, it should never be a thing where equality is now news or groundbreaking. Like, it should have never got to the point where people were treated differently based on, you know, gender, colour of skin, sexuality, all that stuff. We're all part of the same race. Like, the weird equivalent I'll do it with is with, like, animals. For example, dogs. Like, white dogs don't just hang out with other white dogs, or black dogs don't hang out with black dogs, or brown dogs don't hang out with brown dogs. They all hang out with each other because they're the same species and they're all excited to see each other. It seems to be the only species that seems to do that is us. And it's one of those things where it's like, it almost comes across as me being a dick, which, whatever, if that's how you feel, fair enough. But I feel like the worst thing about this planet is the human race. Because we're constantly polluting the planet, we take everything for granted, and especially as the years gone on, especially we've got like with some of the younger generation. There are still some of the younger generation that are actually trying to do something, but a lot of them are so self-entitled and privileged, and everything's handed to them that they expect that for the rest of their life, and they're much worse off. And yeah, this is probably just me being a grumpy old man, but like the whole TikTok challenges and, you know, like Tide Pod challenge and all that stuff. It's like, how dumb are you to do stuff like that? Like, it's just so mind-boggling. And then, like, the younger people would see that and go, yeah, I'll do that too. And then that's when people get killed, or people get arrested, or people do this. And then you go, oh, I saw it on the internet. And it's like, oh. Yeah, it's like, I miss it. It's one of those weird things. It's sort of like, I did grow up with, like, the internet being here. And I know, like, I'm using the internet streaming and all that stuff. But I miss the days where, when you were younger, you had a phone that could only text and call. Like, because the thing that bugs me is just seeing people going out, meeting their friends, and all they do is sit on their phones. It's like, well, what's the point going out then? You could have just done this at home. You know, it's just, I don't know, like, and they're like going out to play, like, football or play Kirby or, like, just have a walk around somewhere, you know, like, I miss those days. Like, oh, you know, I'll sit online and I'll chat to them there and that'll be it. Yeah, if I can physically go out and meet friends, I will, which I do. Normally it's when they invite me because I'm not one for coming up with something to do. But, yeah, you know, it's nice to see them in person, hang out with them. It's a more natural conversation. And, you know, it's just so bizarre that so many people are just so content with sitting on their arse all day. You know, like, the only way they interact with people is on a little screen in front of them. That's how they get their information. It's just news online, like, on social media. It's like, you know, and it's like they read something. It could be from any website and they'll take it so seriously. I think, like, that's the real thing. The amount of times I've had people going, oh, did you know this, this, this? I'm just like, no, it's not. Like, it's someone's writing words on a website and you believed it, you know. And I think I forgot what it was that I saw, but it kind of sums it up nicely. Like, especially when it comes to, like, Facebook and all that stuff. It's like, scientist goes to university, spends 3 years, gets a degree, spends several years researching, like, this scientific discovery. Random Facebook user, that's BS, blah, 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 you know nothing. I know this because blah, blah, blah. It's like, why not listen to the people that have, you know, studied the thing they're talking about? Like, it's one of those odd things. Like, it's just me being, like, an old man, just doing my old man rants. But it's, you know, it's just the fact that people trust their friends over some other things rather than actual, like, scientists and experts. It's like, people are so, like, opinionated on themselves. Like, they hold their opinion in such high regard that it's gospel. And it's like, ugh. I just, like, I can't stand people like that. So, like, it might seem a bit ironic that I'm pretty much doing the same thing now. But, like, I'm not saying that, you know, because I'm saying this, you should listen to me and you should take that into whatever. I'm just basically just saying whatever, and you take it however you want. If you don't like it, fair enough, you know. At the end of the day, it's an opinion. Yeah, it's, I don't know, it's just, people annoy me. Not you people that watch this. I'm appreciative of you watching this, but it's just people in general annoy me. So.
In this lap, push now.
Anyway, rant over. I don't know. I try not to get into it too much, but it's just one of those things that just bugs me. Like, a lot of things bug me. I will rant about it, and then, yeah. Oh, sorry, I'm getting tired. See, that's what it is. I start yawning because I start talking a lot, which is probably why I don't talk as much when I'm gaming. Because it's like, I know it just wears me out just talking. Which is probably, like, a bad idea to, like, do streaming, because you kind of gotta try and keep the entertainment coming.
Exit now. Okay, you only have to stop once now. One stop left.
Oh, 20 laps down, 46 to go.
We're leading our teammate by 22.3 seconds.
Because Hamilton's in the pits now.
Our gap behind is 23.3 seconds.
Oh, that was a much quicker lap, 121.8.
Keep this up.
Oh, Sainz is up to 4th now, Alonso 5th. There we go, like 123 is the average now rather than 124 and a half being a quick lap, so I'll take that. I can only imagine what the I'll be doing after the second stops, probably like 120s or something. Wow, I've already lapped everyone but three drivers. And the player's up to 5th, it's not bad. Signs, Ricardo behind me. So I'm closing on Perez soon then. He'll probably be in the pits in a minute. Help if I didn't spin. Yeah, so, on a lighter note, I'm going back to the OSW review stuff. So ECW December to Dismember, was a one-off WWE ECW pay-per-view in 2006, and is considered one of the worst WWE pay-per-views of all time. They had 4,900 people in attendance, 90,000 pay-per-view buys, which their average was about 230,000 in that year, which still wasn't good. Only announced two matches on the show, I think there's five in total. All pretty much mostly bad. And yeah, it was just a terrible show. It's a bit of a guilty pleasure to watch the Extreme Elimination Chamber match. Spy Fight is rubbish. But yeah. Thank you, Perez. I really want to watch, like, 2008 WWE CW again now. Ah, oh, Marcus Corvon. Such a good theme song. Hello, Shredbacker. You're doing alright in 17th, aren't you? Look at you. You're doing great. Still not lapped Hamilton and Verstappen yet. Forgot about the do-rag Vincent, man. I got distracted by some of these names. Oh, we're almost halfway. Oh. I still managed to lap him. Oh well, oops. Let's rewind that bit. As I was saying that, I noticed Hamilton on the map, so... getting fairly close. Come on, Hamilton, you gotta let me pass now. I tried to spin him out. I did enjoy their review of the happening. Next, it's WWE Capital Carnage 1998. That's what's going to be played in the background. Well, I say that, it's near the end, so. Oh, it's the episode before December, this November. Got Vettel and Stroll in front of us. I still not that Verstappen, he's wily a little.
Start losing some tire grip around now.
Oh, okay. Apparently I'm going to be losing some tire grip. Oh, right, Capital Carnage, the one with Vinnie Jones. Oh, now I get to watch Finley versus Mike Knox. Finley versus 10:15. Yeah, God, why not?
Here's Verstappen. Come here, Verstappen. Go let me pass you. Oh, Verstappen's keeping up with me, that's good.
Oh, nope. It's that corner again.
I think of stuff to talk about. Spun in the corner again. That's what I could talk about. That corner every bloody time.
I think they were meant to race here this year, but due to COVID stuff, they had to skip it.
So they did Austria twice, if I remember correctly.
We're over halfway. It's good. Which I might have said that a few minutes ago. My memory is very terrible nowadays.
Window, you'll be on the mediums.
Don't think I've ever been to Portugal. I think it'd be quite nice. Don't know where I'd go.
Got DRS, have I?
Yes, I have.
Gonna slip past Ocon. Thank you.
Who are we catching up to here? Norris or Ricciardo? That's Metal Slug.
Box, box. We're coming in this lap.
That's Ricciardo. But a different area.
Take their places back. Does Verstappen unlap himself?
Release, release.
Ooh, that's a good pit stop. That's Ocon and Alonso, I believe. And that's Verstappen unlapping himself. Time to go chase him down again.
Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound.
Oh, the Tiffy. Hello. Let's catch up to Verstappen again, so we can relap him. Although he'll probably be in the pits by the time I catch up. No one's been out yet, which is surprising. Unless I've just not clocked him. I've just gone so brain dead during this race that I've just not clocked. Someone is out of the session, but I don't think there is. There he is. Nope.
Hello, Verstappen. Time to give your pace up. Thank you.
I love that he practically stopped for that.
Perez is in the pit. Sainz is up to fourth for now. Ooh, that was a close one. Leclerc almost hit Schumacher.
Go on, Schumacher, slip on the inside. Past Giovinazzi, it's not even Schumacher. Teammate's in the pits.
Lewis is in the pits.
Ah, they're both winning.
Hello, Gasly. Right, we are 2/3 of the way through, pretty much now. I got a purple sector 2. There we go, a new fastest lap by 4/10. Let's see what we can do with this. Hmm. Right, purple sector 1. Are you going much lower in Sector 2 now? It was Vettel and Stroll again, hello. Alright, green sector one this time. Well. Red sector 2 again. Green sector 1 again. I seem to be consistent there, it's just this sector 2 that I slowed down. Or it might just be I did a really good sector 2, so it's took the fastest one, and now it just thinks I'm constantly slower. Yeah, I'm literally 0.005 off the best lap, so it's just this like second half where I'm slowing down. It's getting me through the laps though. But I think that's a benefit I have to when I'm near the end of the race, is I try and push for a new fastest lap. So that's what keeps me motivated to finish. It's 4 in the morning. I think we've been 121. Finish this lap, I've got like 16 laps left. 16 times 120, whatever 3 is, 4 minutes, 5, 20. Oh, I'm going to go in like another 20 minutes. Yeah, an hour 45, yeah, I would have been right. Roughly an hour 45. I got a purple sector 3 somehow. I'd like to question how I got that. Purple sector 1. Alright, I'm getting very quick right now. I don't know where this is coming from. Must be like tyres optimum temperatures. There you go. Got under a 121. The race so far.
Yellow flag.
I think someone's finally out. Someone's slowing down. There we go.
Some information. Oh, on
no, Russell. George Russell in the race.
Green flag.
Thank you. got a purple sector 3 again. Right, I've lapped Hamilton, so I've just got this. Should we see if we can get Verstappen before the end of the race? Should be able to. Oh, Mazepin's out of the session.
Caution, caution.
There he is.
Okay, clear.
There's Verstappen, just seen him on the map. I might be able to catch him. Keeps him in there again. Ah, this corner, I swear to God. Oh, I'm doing terrible on this one. I keep catching the curbs.
Check your MFD for a new...
Let's rewind that. There we go, much better. Alright, let's try and catch Verstappen. Might be an hour 50, hour 55 for this route. Yeah. Oh, is that him right there? Okay, so no problem catching him. Why catch him to the top five as well? Purple sector 2 again. Seems to be doing quite alright there. So I got two purple sectors here, I was still slow. So my sector 1 has been really bad. Someone else out.
Condition is still looking good.
Six laps left. It'll be five after this one. Tires are starting to wear out.
We have 5 laps of fuel remaining.
Take over Sainz and Leclerc.
Okay, Sainz then Leclerc, but Leclerc's started to get away.
Oh, I thought they'd take each other out. Sainz managed to sneak through.
Laps of fuel remaining.
Alright, final lap coming up. I do apologise that I've been fairly quiet.
This
I don't have that
final
rant
final
in the race as well. It's just difficult like doing a long stream and finding stuff to talk about, but I feel like I have to make streams, but like I do want to. It's just difficult trying to fill the time with
talking, especially when I've got no one to interact with. I'm much better when I, like, if someone, like, pops on the chat and, like, asks about stuff, then I can interact that way. But when, like, nothing's there, it's a bit difficult to make a conversation. Schumacher, what did you do to my wing? Have I just took Schumacher out?
There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
Nah, it's fine. It's been interesting doing this. Screw that corner that I keep spinning on. I forgot which one it is. I've gone past it now, but it's so annoying. I'll be intrigued to see how they do when they if they actually do race here. I think apparently they're going back to San Marino, I think. Or is it Imola? Whatever. You know, yeah, which one I mean. Well, they already have. I can't remember. There we go. Victory around the corner. Whoa. What was that, like an hour and a half?
Absolutely roughly? Awesome. Just amazing.
So, well, like, we're approaching an hour 50. It would have been 5 minutes before the race. The qualifying.
They take the checkered flag.
Several flashbacks.
After an excellent performance at the...
Yeah. Yeah, there we go. I'm not worried about maximising this tier, to be honest. I already did it for the first one.
After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Carlos Sainz certainly
wasn't. Yeah, just over an hour and a half,
19
minutes,
29
seconds.
Pinpoint precision,
so, I'd say about...
Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend
of
racing.
10 minutes was spent on flashbacks.
And we'll see you for the next one.
About 7, 8 minutes was spent on flashbacks, probably. Yeah, there we go. Won that one. So yeah, thank you for watching this. I'll be putting it on YouTube so you can watch it there. I do apologise, I was quiet for a majority of it. This is probably why, because the more I talk, the more I start to yawn, because I get worn out. It is 20 past 4, almost, in the morning. But I will be back tomorrow with a stream. Don't know what I'll be streaming. I've been playing a lot of Forager again. I've really enjoyed that. I've maximized my levels, got all the skills. I'm just working on, like, constructing certain stuff. But yeah, YouTube, Twitter, Instagram, it's all rbillington94, twitch.tv/rbillington, Array Gaming, use promo code RyanBillington, 10% off. Thank you for watching this, and I will see you in the next one. All right, bye.